And welcome back to the next episode of Let's Play Hearts of Iron 4 with the Avalanche Patch and the Blood Alone DLC. Playing as the United States of America, and we are continuing on here. Let's check the Japanese. They are nastily taking the east coast of China. They have taken the capital a while ago. And after that, they've just poured over them, so we will see what happens. I think it's sometime in the middle of 41 we will be attacked by them. I'm not entirely sure. 35 steel. Holy fuck. Are you serious? Okay, we're saving up for that export focus in trade loss to keep more steel at home. And it's percentage based, so that means we are extracting a lot of steel. That's our second best resource after oil. So because of this huge extraction number, we will get so much more from it when the percentage go up by 30%. Yeah, let's do that. And then when this one is maxed, but we'll still need naval experience for upgrades and stuff. So how is it going for that chassis? It's done in 61 days now. Lovely. And the naval treaty has ended in the end of the former episode. So that means we can build our ships however we want them. I'm just waiting for October here. October 17 to get the heavy cruiser done. Then I will change it and add one more row of cannons as well. The fall of Warsaw, yeah, right. Here we go. Germany overrunning Poland. They push their pressure on Benelux area. That means attacking Netherlands, Belgium, France. Oh, right. Nice, that is going fast. So, how many ports do we have left here? None. So I want to build more ports. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then go military factories. Yeah. In between, like this. You can also prioritize these four. And of course, they who are being constructed there. Right. Our War Plans Division is on the way. And we have started our intelligence agency. Office of Strategic Services, the future CIA. So let's go with the passive defense to begin with. We're going to keep it active constantly with the in development. Poland capitulated. So that means the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact will be honored soon enough. Yeah, there we go. Soviet Union took a huge portion of Poland. We got some more radars here. 41. That means we're going with research speed to have better computers. Deploy those troops. There we go. Netherlands attacked by Germany. Yeah, we can take some of the troops here then. Pay farm subsidies. No. No. Nah. Netherlands capitulated. It's going fast. Belgium is now attacked. Denmark is now attacked. Norway is now attacked by the German Reich. And now the world tension is up at 92. We need more artillery, anti-tank, and support equipment, so reduce a little bit on infantry equipment. Here, here. That will do fine, I guess. We're producing ships pretty fast now. $48.58.52, so let's go here. Panay incident. Yeah, this affects us. I think Japan mistakenly shut down one of our ships. Exactly. So passive defense. Belgium capitulated. So here it goes. USS Panay, this is our ship, is sunk in China. The gunboat USS Panay came under the under fire earlier today while evacuating civilians from the front line in the war between Japan and China, despite being clearly marked with American flags. Struck with two bombs, she sank later that day with three US citizens killed and many more wounded. Survivors were picked up by American and British gunboats in the area. Japan has been quick to claim it was an accident and offers an apology. But some think that the attack was deliberate. A number of advisors are calling for war. How should we respond? So no, we are not the one declaring the war, because we will lose a lot of stability on that. But you could go to war earlier here, as a democratic USA. And yeah, it is both positive and negative, but no. I don't want to play the role as an aggressor here. If this is an aggressor, maybe this is a defensive reaction. But they get a firm warning. So if this is happening again, then it's definitely war. No questions about this. Withdraw forces from China. No, that's weakness. Demand compensation. That means war support. So demand compensation from Japan, and we also need a spy. My favorite spy are the seducers, but I want the women to be the seducers. That has to be the best spy you can get in the world. A seductive, good-looking female spy. You cannot resist. So, but Frank Davis, I don't like the seduction thing anyway, so we will go with that. Luxembourg is attacked, and we also need to continue on with this passive defense. Nine more days and we can start building our planes to fill up the ranks of, so we have 14 carrier fighters. So here we can also see which ship has been filled up with those planes, and the same here. So yes, Luxembourg has capitulated. Japan agrees to provide compensation. We have received response from the Japanese ambassador agreeing to our demand of compensation for the sinking of USS Panay. While public attitudes in the United States towards Japan will be influenced by these events for some time to come, war has been averted. So we gain 100 political power for that. That means we can go with the trade law thing right away. Export focus, here we come. So we have 52 political power left. The air war plans division is almost done. Perfect. Air Warplans Division. Yeah, so now we're up at 95 air experience. Air support, that's close air support reduction in cost when we're building them. First special, no, Louisiana, maybe. Yes, yes. We are a bit behind when it comes to the doctrines in the superior firepower tree, I think. Mobilization speed, faster. Louisiana maneuvers is tempting. Air support is also tempting, but we're not producing close air supports right now anyway. So that's okay. Escort effort is also tempting, but I think Louisiana maneuvers will be our next thing to go for here. We also have the Lend-Lease, but I'm, as I told you before, I'm not going to do Lend-Lease. Louisiana maneuvers, yes. Oh, right, battlefield support, that's us. 50% cheaper, but we will pay... No, we need all those experience points for creating planes right now. So that would have been a stupid move. So I'm just waiting for one more day. Improve small airframe. Here we go. Medium. The next one will be this. Could go with better cannons. No, 672 days. No, we're skipping that for now. I'm tempted to get more research here, but then we need new 1940 models of ships as well. But we also need artillery. Prepare for the tanks and all of this, so... Oh my god. Yeah, better anti-tank stuff. Yeah, improved... So we got these two from that research. Improved small airframe and improved carrier airframe. We're going with the carrier airframe. So, let's do that right now. Improved carrier airframe. This is new. I've looked a bit on YouTube at it, but let's try it ourselves here. Two engines, maybe. We want... These are being the fighters now, so... We have the 4x light machine gun or heavy machine gun. I think we can go light machine gun. That is... That is air attack plus... Yeah, gives us 8. Weight 9. For heavy, that is the same weight, but better air attack. So what's the drawback here? Air attack, weight. When on logistics strikes, 1. That one is better. 2x the cannon, that is 20, but agility goes down here a lot with the cannons. So agility, we want very good agility. But then again, agility goes down by 6. The weight also goes up a lot. So heavy machine gun seems like the thing for us here. Another group of them, and then we can go light machine guns maybe, just to combine. And if that's good or bad, I don't know, but it's cool. Radio navigation, yes. We also want special modules, extra fuel tanks. This is pretty cheap so far. And the last one will be... Self-sealing, what the hell does that mean? I guess that's air defense. Why is air defense minus 9 right now? Why is that minus 9? Strat bombing. Night penalty. Yeah, radio navigation is awesome to increase night attacks. So... Okay, the drop tanks. No, extra fuel tanks, they reduce air defense quite a lot. I don't know if that's worth it then. I don't know. I want the air defense to be How many hits a plane can take before... No, yes. No, we're not going with extra fuel tanks. Yeah, so the air defense, yes. If you hit that fuel tank, they go up in flames a lot easier than... That's true. Armor plates. That reduces range because the weight becomes a problem, I guess. Yeah. Get two weight, but yeah. Dive brakes, self-sealing fuel tanks is something we could go for together with the extra fuel tanks. So these two together, they are awesome. And this cost me only 15 points. And I like that picture, so we're going to use it. And now change the picture, okay. Fuck. I want that picture because I like it. There we go. So that's improved carrier. So how many are we missing here? So if I'm producing... Yeah, we will see. Let's go with... I think we need to prioritize this. So reduce the infantry equipment a lot to get those that plane production. And that goes before this as well. Yes. Yeah, we can only have 1-5 there. That would do great. Reduce one artillery. Reduce one there. And here. We need a lot more military factories. So now we are producing... We will see when it goes forward here. We can also construct the other frames. Two engines. Yeah, two engines increases the fuel usage as well, but thrust is very good. So this will be the naval bomber now. So we need naval bomber torpedoes. And can I only take them once, okay. So maybe we should have some fighter weapons as well then. Light machine guns. Right. Let's see. Yeah, the weight goes up, so, but light machine guns, fine. And I think that will be it. And then we have the extra fuel tanks with the self-sealing fuel tanks. And the radars. The radio navigation twos. So, no. Extra fuel tank seems like a dumb idea here, because they're just going out for bomb, and then they go home, so we're not going to use that. I want these the floats. Why can't I use the floats? They were crossed out. How could I select it? Oh, I could. The speed is agility and everything. Goes down. But the air defense is better. Fuel usage. Surface. Yeah, I think floats are very good. They can be very close to the water and see what's down there. Dive brakes. No, that's more for CASs, I think. No strategic material usage. Drop tanks. Give our fighters some extra range. Armor plates, no. Defensive turrets. I think that's more for the bombers. And then we can go radio navigation. No, not two of them. Why? We don't need that. Bomb sites, maybe. Complex mechanical view that takes... Thermovers, altitudes, bombardier to drop bombs with high... Are those CAS? Does that count for what we are doing? It increases... I think bomb sites are good. We cannot have floats. Why? Why the fuck not? Why the fuck not? I don't get why. Too many weapons in the way, maybe? The fuck? Why? It does not tell me why. Anti-tank cannon. Drop tanks then. Okay, so that's fuel tanks you're dropping later on, so they do not hinder you in fight. They give you fuel until you reach combat, and then I don't think the bombers will need that. So I think this is fine. So we have them. I want another picture that looks very naval bombery. That looks naval bombery to me. We can put it out here for now already. Oh no, the Wildcat will be there, and we can add the Avenger. The Avenger is the naval bomber. Wildcat is the fighter. All of these are carrier models, and then we're going to produce the CAS, the close air support plane. Bomb blocks. Small bomb bay, anti-tank cannons. Yeah, small bomb bay, I guess. And then bomb blocks. The fuck does that do then? Weight, agility. Agility. Small bomb bay. What does that do? Oh, agility minus... Okay, minus 20. When on close air support, logistic strikes. Oh, naval strike. Agility minus 50, naval attack 2. I think we should have that, yes. We can go with it there and have another CAS small bomb bay here. Engines, two of them. Radio navigation. Fuel tanks. Be a hot time in the town of I still don't get why we don't have floats. Maybe we're too low on tech or something. Maybe you need to research the floats. No. Yeah, extra fuel tanks and the fuel self-sealing there. Change the picture to this one. Rubber. Here we go. Now it's rubber time. Yeah, we can still do this though. So formation flying, fighter detection, air wing mission. Yeah, do that. So now we're down to 3 experience again. We're low on it, so... So this means we are producing 2 planes a week. And this will rise when... Yeah, the efficiency goes up here on these factories. The more you produce, the more the efficiency will go up, so... electric torpedo. Yeah, and we also... One thing to very easily forget here... is, let's see here, yeah, we can go with shell dice here, spend 50. One thing that is very easily to forget here is that you need to change the carriers. Heavy cruiser. Where do we lack heavy cruisers? 4, 5. No, 4, 4, 10. So that means you will go to the first fleet. So here we go. Where are you? You're here. So here we have Saratoga, Lexington, and Enterprise. That means we're going to get rid of all. Yeah. Planes are not training there anymore. I think I will stop training with these for a while. It's time to stop the exercises on Navy to be able to change. So everybody goes to the same port, are you fucking kidding me? Yeah, we need to disband these. And also the fighter carrier. Oh, these are close air supporters. How many do those do we have again? 38 for carriers. And 18 carrier fighters and 17 naval bombers. Those are old models and we almost have none of them. So that means we're going to get rid of every plane possible. So let's select here, disband all the air wings, yes. Disband all the air wings. There we go. How many carriers did we have? 5, yes. So this is Ranger and Yorktown. So here we're going to add the new models for, yeah, what we got. So the Wildcats. The Wildcat model. Ah, we can only add that for now, so that means we can skip this for now. We don't need to be in training anymore with... We can train with the subs. That is entirely possible. Yeah, we can train with everybody again. And if they don't train, they need to repair, and then they will repair, so that's okay. I want them to repair right now. So we're done here, that's 800 days, 600 days, no. So we are done with planes for now here, completely. We need to get going with the engineer company. We also need to go with the invasion technology. Yeah, deploy these guys and the marine. Go here. All in. Ready. No, these are new forces. That is true. We can go to North Carolina here. North Carolina with trains, and they will need a new army under William Simpson. And he will also need a field marshal, that is Dwight D. Eisenhower. And he will need trucks. And we're going to train organization first and stuff like that. So that will be the Europe army. Damn, that's taking a long time for them to move. Maybe they should stop training, maybe that will go faster. I think so. I don't know. Iceland take control of foreign affairs, so they are now known as Iceland only, with no faction. Italy is also in the war. They are fighting together with the German Reich against the Allies now. And France is being torn apart fast. And that's early. We're not even into 1940 right now. This is something that happened then. Oh, interesting. Mexican oil nationalized. Lázaro Cárdenas has been stirring up populist nonsense aimed against our economy, economic interests in Mexico. And now the Partido Revolucionario Institucional has passed legislation to nationalize the assets of Royal Dutch Shell, Standard Oil of California, and many other international oil firms. Although their constitution allows this action, international justice demands compensation for the losses suffered by the firms. The oil barons are demanding we act. Okay, it's a fait. There's nothing we can do. Yes, it is. We will embargo trade with Mexico until they come to their senses. So trade relations between us will go down. We will, they will embargo us. So our option, we don't need their oil. So our options are limited and force of arms must be considered. No, not that aggressive. Another past stage is nationally the assets of Royal Dutch Shell. All the records. No. We will embargo trade with them. France capitulated. The fall of Paris. That's sad. The flight of Rudolf Hess. So now they lost him, right? Yeah. What will be the next move here? War economy, not yet really. Extensive conscription, not yet, but it's close that we are going to need. We need one here. General Electric. No, it was the General Motors we got from research. So it will be General Motors. If we're going to have one. And also we have the Air Force Commander. We can almost get him. No, they cost... Yeah. Air experience gained. Night operation penalty. Air accidents. I do like Carl Spatz. Can get him now if we want to. Yeah, we will get Carl Spatz for the Air Force. And we need spirits for them as well. We can also get another spirit for the Navy here. Close combat, screen attack, torpedo screen penetration. Surprise attacks. Night fighting. Efficient communication. I do like that, efficient communications. That's America in a nutshell. In inclement weather experience. No, I don't like... No. Brave commanders. Ordnance. So efficient communication sounds cool as fuck. Okay, steal from France. Yeah, true. True. France is no longer there almost, so... we can shut down this completely. And then trade... Ah, we don't need steel anymore. Oh, I should have shut that down earlier. Chromium we do need still. A little bit, because we don't extract. We extract 2, so that is there's no difference. We're extracting 0 of rubber. So that will be the same, even though with the export focus. Steel is now so much higher. So we're now self-sufficient in steel again. By far. So that means we get a lot of more factories for other shit here we can do. Yeah, Yeah, we're building our planes. We're building these as well. So we need to get a stockpile of those planes. 382 are fighter planes. Should I add that right now? I need to figure that out. We need to end the episode, but I need to figure that out right away. We only have 20 so far. But we can add 10. So add 2 tens. On Saratoga, yes. So we'll now fill it up slowly. And it's being produced faster and faster here. Yeah, it's going up. So now we're producing 5 planes a week. And it will go much faster later on. We'll get another 5 factories dedicated to it as well. That will mark the end of this episode, and I thank you very much for watching. I hope you still are with me here. Things are starting to heat up, but we will wait until 1941 until we enter the war. But it's heartbreaking to see Europe fall apart while we are waiting. And here is the progress of Japan so far. They have cut China off from the sea. They are in a very bad position. I will see you next time. Thank you very much for watching and take care. Bye.